Hey, welcome back to another video. Today I want to show you two new devices or presets I created for Bitwig Studio 3 that you can use. And the first one is called Stereo Boy. And in this grid preset here, I used basically an audio input and split it into two paths. And one is going to an stereo splitter, and the left and the right channel are going to all pass devices, and then are going back to a stereo merge and then to the output or the output mixer. And the second path is going to the same splitter, and there's a delay, and these delays for the left and the right channel are modulated slowly. And you can define some of the parameters here on the front end, basically, with the macro knobs. And you can turn in the two paths. So this is the first one, and this is the second path here. And if you just want only the delays for some kind of VR effect, then you can just dial this in here, or can just use the mix to mix it with a tri-signal. So I show you the sound without this device. This is how it sounds. So a pretty basic pad sound with the polysynth. And when we turn on the Stereo Boy here and use the VR effect, which gives us some kind of pitch up and down modulation, then it sounds like this. And I call the Stereo Boy because the left and the right delay is different modulated or randomly modulated. So it gives you a nice stereo effect or makes the sound wider without tweaking the initial source sound here. And the second path you can dial in additionally gives you some kind of delay effect, and it sounds like this. Or let's try and make the sound a bit shorter so you can hear the delay effect. So if you have the timing at 0%, you basically have a pretty short delay. And when you use this knob here, you make the two all-pass devices at the same time. You change the delay time of these two all-passes together, basically. And if you use this knob here, you can skew it. So if you turn it right, all the way to the right, then basically this is longer delay and this is a shorter delay on the left side here. If you turn it the other way around, then basically this is completely short delay and this is a long delay. So you can change the levels for left and right. And this gives you even more a wider sound, or makes the sound a bit wider in the stereo field. Thank you. So it gives a small or light flavor of an analog synthesizer, where everything is not so precise, right? And yeah, this is my GitHub repository, and you can download now. And the second device I created is this Crane Reverb here. And that's a bit more complicated than the first one, because this is adding different pitches to the sound. So for instance, when we go in with a single sound into the Crane Reverb here, the first layer pitches the sound to one octave above the root sound, okay? And then we have a second layer, and I use two pitch shifters with one octave, so we have two octaves, and so on, until we hit the last layer where we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pitch shifters. And after the pitch shifters, we have always on every layer a filter, a low cut filter, and a reverb. And you can change all the settings for the layers here in the front. So when we change the grain rate, for instance, here, we change on every layer the grain rate on the pitch shifter. This is how it sounds. So this is without. So the grain rate can change the sound drastically, and also the mix. So when you look at the second layer here, you can change the mix of the two pitch shifters. And what this means is that when you have the grain mix at 0%, the sound goes completely untouched through the pitch shifters here. If you turn it all the way up, then you have basically a pitch here at this point to one octave above, and then a second octave higher, because this device here doesn't get the dry signal because we have the mix at 100%, right? So when you go into the middle position here to 50%, then you have kind of the mixed one octave above pitch signal from this device, and then this device too, and the pitched unpitched tri signal that's going through. So there's a bit of multiple voices going on, that layering on top of each other. So this gives these nice thick reverb sound in the end. Also, the crane rate here is modulated with a random modulator, and you can change the speed of this random modulator here, and this gives you also a bit of changes over time. So you have basically, I try to make as a living or alive as possible. That's just the amount of modulation that is applied to the grain rates here, and this is the speed. Okay, You also can influence this low pass filter here at the end with this knob here, as you can see. And the only difference between the layers here is that I use different default settings for the cutoff. I think I start with C3 for this layer here, and here I choose C4, C5, C6, and C7, and from this default point I add the cutoff modulation with this knob here. So it's a bit, so there's an offset on each layer for the cutoff, basically. Okay, then I have this crazy pan macro here, and this does nothing special. The first layer here is basically straight in the center, and when I turn this crazy pan here up, then nothing happens to this layer. This is basically always in the center, but the second one is completely panned to the left, the next one is panned to the right, and then left again and right again. And if you turn this down, then you can see it goes back to the center. So all layers are in the center. So if you have this left, completely left, all layers are in the center. And if you turn this to the right, then some layers are basically positioned more right and more left. And this gives you some kind of an orchestral, yeah, setup. So where not everything comes from the middle, so some voices come from the left and some from the right. So yeah, two new devices for you to download, and yeah, tell me what you think, write it in the comments, and thanks for watching, and I see you in the next video. Bye.